लेट्स स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 46. फॉलोइंग इज द बैलेंस शीट ऑफ एक्स लिमिटेड एज 31st मार्च 2018. शेयर कैपिटल वेयर बी रिकॉर्डेड इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी. रिजर्व एंड सरप्लस इट विल गो इन ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी. लॉन्ग टर्म बोरोइंग फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी. शॉर्ट टर्म बोरोइंग मे बी इट इज रिकॉर्डेड अंडर करंट लाइबिलिटी बट शॉर्ट टर्म बोरोइंग्स आर एक्चुअली रिकॉर्डेड इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी. Short term provision, let's see what is given in short term provision. In short term provision, provision for tax is given. So short term provision will go in operating activity. Tangible assets, investing activity. Intangible assets, earlier it was 3, now it is 2. It means it will come in operating activity, amortization. Non-current investment will be recorded under investing activity. Current investment, cash and cash equivalent. Inventories, operating activity, and this is cash and cash equivalent. All points are clear. Where do we record? Fine. So again, notes to account is given. So surplus under operating, 12% debenture under financing activity, bank overdraft financing, provision for tax operating, machinery investing activity. Okay, and depreciation is given. So let us check what can we do. Additional information is also given. Rupees 1 lakh debentures were issued on 1st April 17. When it is issued on 1st April 17, so you can see the date 31st March 17, hai na? 31st March 18. So this is current year, this is previous year. And the debentures are issued on 1st April. It means this 5 lakh rupees debenture is in closing balance, 4 lakh is opening balance. But when we have issued on the first day of the year. It means we will calculate interest on debenture on 5 lakh, not on 4 lakh. Remember this point. In this question, interest on debenture will be 12%, debenture will be computed on 5 lakh, not on 4 lakh opening value. Because this 1 lakh rupees debenture is issued on the very first day of this year, according to adjustment. Then during the year, second adjustment, a piece of machinery costing 80 on which accumulated tap was 40 sold at a gain of 10. So let's see one adjustment. Let me start question number 46. First I will prepare one working note. What is the cost of machine according to question? According to question, the cost of machine is 80,000. Accumulated debt is given. Accumulated debt means total debt on this machine was 40,000. So after subtracting total debt, what we get? 40,000. This is written down value, or we can say book value of machine on the date. Sold at a gain of 10,000. Sold at a gain of 10,000. So at what price it is sold? It is sold for rupees 50,000. So this is your working note number 1. Then remember one thing, whenever any machinery has been sold, it is always better to prepare machinery account. Okay. And in this question, there is one more thing. You can see accumulated depreciation opening and closing is given. You can note down this point. If accumulated debt opening and closing balance is given and anything is mentioned in adjustment, then we need to prepare accumulated depreciation account also. Okay, so first I will prepare machinery account. Working note number 2, machinery account. Okay. Yes, machine account starts from debit side. What we write? We write opening balance to balance brought down. The opening balance of machine is given. How much? 20 lakh. क्लोजिंग बैलेंस विल कम इन क्रेडिट साइड बाय बैलेंस कैरिड डाउन 26 लाख. देन यू कैन सी वन मशीन इज सोल्ड फॉर 50,000 एंड एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप इज 40,000 हियर. सो बाय एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट, एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट 40,000, दैट मशीन इज सोल्ड फॉर रुपीज 50,000. सो बाय बैंक अकाउंट 50,000, गेन ऑफ रुपीज 10,000 ऑन सेल ऑफ ए मशीन. टू स्टेटमेंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस, गेन इज रिकॉर्डेड इन डेबिट साइड 10,000 रुपीज. लेट मी टेक आउट द बैलेंस, लेट सी वेयर बैलेंस इज रिमेनिंग. तो 26,90,000, 26,90,000, 26,90,000 माइनस 20,10,000, तो 6,80,000 इज रिमेनिंग इन द डेबिट साइड. इफ 6,80,000 इज रिमेनिंग इन द डेबिट साइड, व्हाट डज इट मीन? दिस इज डियर चिल्ड्रन परचेज ऑफ मशीन, रिमेंबर. ओके, सो इट विल बी रिकॉर्डेड अंडर इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी. सो दिस परचेज एंड दिस सेल्स, दीज टू आइटम्स आर रिकॉर्डेड अंडर इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी. Now I have explained that if opening and closing balance of accumulated debt is given and anything is given in adjustment about accumulated debt, we need to prepare accumulated depreciation account. So working note number 3. Accumulated depreciation account. From where it starts? Accumulated depreciation account starts from the credit side. What do we write first? Opening balance by balance brought down. Let's see opening balance. Opening balance is given 1 lakh and closing balance is given 2 lakh. 2 balance carried down. Now let's see what is given in the question. It is given accumulated debt was 40,000 on the machine which has been sold to machine account. Accumulated debt was 40,000. So let's do the total. What we get? 2,40,000. Balance is remaining in credit side. If balance remains in credit side, what does it mean? This 1,40,000 is your current year depreciation by depreciation account. This is your current year debt, and current year debt is recorded in operating activity. So all working notes are over in this question, I think. Yes, both working notes are over, hana? So let's prepare cash flow statement. Ready? Cash flow statement. First activity is cash flow from operating activity. Cash flow from operating activities. From where do we start? We start from surplus. Let us see how much it is given. Hana? So surplus is given. Earlier it was 3 lakh, now it is 6 lakh. Surplus 3 lakh. 6 lakh minus 3 lakh, hai na? And then what we write? We write current year provision for tax. It is given here. करंट ईयर प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स इज 2 लाख, एप्रोप्रिएशन प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स ऑफ करंट ईयर 2 लाख, देन ट्रांसफर टू जनरल रिजर्व नॉट गिवन, डिविडेंड, डिविडेंड इज ऑल्सो नॉट गिवन इन दिस क्वेश्चन, है ना, डिविडेंड इज ऑल्सो नॉट गिवन इन दिस क्वेश्चन. सो 3 + 2 5 लाख, नेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स, एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी आइटम्स आर नॉट गिवन. देन वॉट वी एड नॉन कैश एक्सपेंस, सो लेट सर्च नॉन कैश एक्सपेंस आर गिवन और नॉट. फर्स्ट नॉन कैश एक्सपेंस इज डेप्रिसिएशन ऑफ करेंट ईयर. सो डेप्रिसिएशन ऑफ करेंट ईयर वी हैव कंप्यूटर चिल्ड्रन 1,40,000 इन अबव वर्किंग नोट. सो 1,40,000 डेप्रिसिएशन ऑफ करेंट ईयर. देन वी हैव सीन गुडविल, अर्लियर इट वॉज 3 लाख, नाउ इट इज 2 लाख, सो गुडविल रिटर्न ऑफ 1 लाख, है ना, गुडविल रिटर्न ऑफ, और यू कैन राइट एमोर्टाइजेशन, है ना, 1 लाख. सो नॉन कैश एक्सपेंसेस आर ओवर. देन वॉट वी एड नॉन ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसेस, नॉन ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसेस लाइक इंटरेस्ट ऑन बोरिंग वॉज गिवन, सो वी नीड टू राइट 12% इंटरेस्ट ऑन बोरिंग. एंड आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन दैट वी नीड टू कंप्यूट ऑन 5 लाख, है ना, बिकॉज 1 लाख डिबेंचर वर इशूड ऑन द फर्स्ट डे ऑफ द ईयर, दैट्स व्हाई. सो 12% ऑफ 5 लाख इंटरेस्ट ऑन डिबेंचर, इंटरेस्ट ऑन डिबेंचर्स 5 लाख इंटू 12%, 12 × 5 = 60,000. Is there any loss on asset, sale of asset? No. There is gain on sale of asset. That is 10,000. So that is income. Hai na? That is non-operating income. So what we do, we subtract non-operating income. Non-operating income. What is given? Gain on sale of machine. Gain on sale of machine. How much? 10,000. That will be subtracted. And when we add or less all these items, now what we get? Let me check. 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 lakh minus 10,000. 7,90,000. 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 minus 10. 790,000. It is known as operating profit before working capital changes. Now what we do, we need to adjust work current assets and current liabilities. Adjustment for working capital changes. So let's see what are the current assets and current liabilities which are given. We start with current liabilities. Short term borrowing will record it under financing activity. Short term provision we have already recorded, 2,165,000 we need to record. Current assets, only inventories are given, है ना, only inventories are given. Earlier it was 130, now it is 260, so increase in inventories by 130. Increase in inventories by 1,30,000. Increase in inventory is results in outflow of cash, and there is no point, so let us subtract it. 7,90,000 minus 1,30,000, so I think 6,60,000. Then what to do? Then finally we need to pay tax. Less tax paid. What is tax paid, children? Provision for tax, hai na? Provision for tax of the previous year is considered as tax paid, 1,65,000. So 1,65,000 tax paid. So let me subtract it, and then we check 6,60,000 minus 1,65,000. So it is coming 4,95,000 positive. इफ इट कम्स पॉजिटिव देन व्हाट वी कॉल इट कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटीज. ओके इज दैट क्लियर. लेट अस चेक कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम ऑपरेटिंग 495. यस ओके. सो लेट्स बिगिन सेकेंड एक्टिविटी कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी. कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटीज. व्हाट डू वी राइट इन इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी? वी राइट नॉन करेंट एसेट्स प्लस नॉन करेंट इन्वेस्टमेंट. सो लेट अस सी व्हाट नॉन करेंट एसेट्स आर गिवन. चिल्ड्रन वी हैव प्रिपेयर्ड मशीन अकाउंट है ना इन द बिगिनिंग. सो यू कैन सी इन मशीन अकाउंट परचेज ऑफ मशीन 680,000. परचेज ऑफ मशीन 680,000 रिजल्ट इन आउटफ्लो ऑफ कैश. ओके एंड सेल ऑफ मशीन 50,000 रिजल्ट इन इनफ्लो ऑफ कैश. सेल ऑफ मशीन 50,000 रिजल्ट इन इनफ्लो ऑफ कैश. लेट अस सी इफ एनीथिंग एल्स इज गिवन. टेंजिबल एसेट्स मशीनरी इज ओवर. ओके एंड नॉन करेंट इन्वेस्टमेंट इज ऑल्सो गिवन. नॉन करेंट इन्वेस्टमेंट इज ऑल्सो गिवन. हाउ मच? अर्लियर इट वॉज 2 lakh, नाउ इट इज 3 lakh. सो वॉट डज इट मीन? इट मीन्स परचेज ऑफ नॉन करेंट इन्वेस्टमेंट बाय रुपीज 1 lakh. परचेज ऑफ नॉन करेंट इन्वेस्टमेंट बाय रुपीज 1 lakh. वेन वी परचेज इट इज आउटफ्लो ऑफ कैश. यस और नो? 2 to 3 lakh. आई थिंक एवरीथिंग इज ओवर अंडर नॉन करेंट एसेट्स एंड नॉन करेंट इन्वेस्टमेंट. यस ऑल दिस पॉइंट्स आर ओवर. फाइन सो लेट्स डू द टोटल. 680 प्लस 1 780 माइनस 50 730,000. 730,000 नेगेटिव. सो दिस इज कैश यूज्ड इन इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी. इजंट इट और नॉट? लेट मी चेक. 730,000 कैश यूज्ड. ओके फाइन लेट्स चेक फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी. थर्ड एक्टिविटी कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटीज. इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी व्हाट डू वी राइट? इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी वी राइट शेयर होल्डर फंड प्लस नॉन करेंट लायबिलिटी है ना. सो लेट्स चेक शेयर होल्डर फंड. शेयर कैपिटल अर्लियर 17 लाख नाउ इट इज 19 लाख. इश्यू ऑफ शेयर कैपिटल बाय 2 लाख. इश्यू ऑफ शेयर कैपिटल बाय रुपीज 2 लाख रिजल्ट इन इनफ्लो ऑफ कैश. Then long-term borrowing, earlier it was 4 lakh, now it is 5 lakh. Increase in long-term borrowing, 1 lakh. Increase in long-term borrowing by rupees 1 lakh, result in inflow of cash. Then short-term borrowing, number 3, let's see what is given in number 3. Number 3, it is bank overdraft. Earlier it was 175, now it is 170. Decrease in bank overdraft by 5,000. Decrease in bank overdraft by 5,000 result in outflow of cash. Isn't it or not? Hai na? Let's see what. Yes, 12% interest on debenture is also to be paid. Interest on debenture 12%. Hai na? So we have already computed. 12% of 5 lakh is 60,000. Okay, so just check once again. एनी पॉइंट इज एनी पॉइंट लेफ्ट, ऑल पॉइंट्स आर ओवर आई थिंक, है ना। सो लेट्स डू द टोटल। 2 + 1 3, 3 लाख माइनस 65, 2 लाख 35,000 पॉजिटिव वैल्यू। इट मीन्स दिस इज कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी, कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी। नाउ व्हाट टू डू, वी नीड टू ऐड ऑल दिस थ्री, 235, 730 एंड 495। सो लेट मी चेक, 495 प्लस 2,35,000 माइनस 7,30,000 nil. So what do we write? No flow, isn't it? Then what we do here, we need to add. What to add? Opening cash and cash equivalent. So let me check, what is opening cash and cash equivalent in this question? 40,000. 70 must come. Achha, 40 + 170, 40 + 170 hai na. So 40 + 170 is 2,10,000. 40,000 plus 1,70,000 is equal to 2,10,000. So closing cash and cash equivalent also must come 2,10,000. Closing cash and cash equivalent, let us check, 1,40,000 and 70,000. Yes, correct. 1,40,000 plus 70,000 is equal to 2,10,000. So I hope, dear children, the question is clear to everyone. Question number 47. Following was the balance sheet of MM Limited. Share capital, financing activity, reserve and surplus, operating activity, long term borrowing, financing activity, short term borrowing, financing activity, short term provision, operating activity, tangible assets, investing, intangible assets, earlier it was 30, now it is 20, operating activity, non current investment, investing activity, current investment and cash equivalent, cash and cash equivalent, cash and cash equivalent, inventory is operating activity, reserve and surplus operating activity, long term borrowing financing activity, bank overdraft financing activity, provision for tax operating activity, machinery investing activity, accumulated debt we need to calculate, current year depreciation will be recorded under operating activity, goodwill earlier 30 now 20 operating activity, inventories operating activity, and additional information is given. 12% debentures were redeemed on 31st March 15. Okay, 31st March 15. So children, earlier it was 5 lakh, now it is 450. So 50,000 of debenture has been repaid. Redeem means repaid. When repaid? 31st March 15. If it is repaid on 31st March 15, it means whole year we have rupees 5 lakh. Say yes or no. If whole year we have 5 lakh rupees debenture, it means we will calculate interest on debenture 12% on rupees 5 lakh. Is that clear to everyone? So the first point is over. Second, tax 70,000 was paid during the year. If tax is paid during the year it is given, and provision for tax opening and closing are given, it means we need to prepare provision for tax account. So in this question, first we will prepare provision for tax account. Question number 47. provision for tax account. This is your first working note. Provision for tax starts from credit side. What do we write? Opening balance by balance brought down. Opening balance is given 90,000. To balance carried down. Closing balance is given 70,000. In adjustment, it is mentioned tax 70,000 was paid during the year to bank. Tax paid during the year is 70,000. This is tax paid. Where do balance remain? In credit side. So 1,40,000 minus 90,000 is equal to 50,000. What does this mean? By statement of profit and loss. And this is your provision for tax of current year. Remember, where do we write provision for tax of current year? In operating activity. Let's begin cash flow from operating activities. Cash flow statement. Okay. First activity is cash flow from operating activity. And we begin with the surplus. So let us see how much it is given. It is given, earlier it was 50,000, now it is 2 lakh. Earlier it was minus 50, you know? Now it is 2 lakh. So tell me, what will be the surplus during year? Current year minus previous year. So minus 50 minus 2 lakh. So it will be 2,50,000. Yes or no? Huh? It will be 2,50,000. Then we need to add some appropriations. One appropriation is given here, provision for tax of current year. Provision for tax of current year, 50,000. Let's see if there is any other appropriations are given, like transfer to reserve. Dividend not given, you know? It is not given. So 2,50,000 plus 50, 3,00,000. Net profit before tax. Okay. Then what we write, we add non-cash expense. Let's see non-cash expense are given or not. Depreciation and other thing. So accumulated debt is given. So let us take the difference of these two, 2 lakh minus 1 lakh 1,000, 99,000. So depreciation will be, current year depreciation will be 99,000. Okay, and goodwill is given. So you can see earlier goodwill was 30, now it is 20. So decrease in goodwill means amortization of goodwill, goodwill written off 10,000. Hai na? Goodwill written off, or you can write goodwill amortized 10,000. Now we need to add non-operating expenses. Non-operating expenses. Under non-operating expenses, what do we write? We write interest on debentures, which we need to calculate on 5 lakh, 12,5 is 60,000. So interest on debentures. 60,000 विल कम, 5 लाख इंटू 12%, है ना। एंड लेट अस सी इज देयर एनी लॉस और एनी अदर थिंग इज गिवन इन एडजस्टमेंट, नो नथिंग इज गिवन, नॉन ऑपरेटिंग इनकम्स आर नॉट गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन, है ना। सो लेट अस डू द टोटल, लेट मी डू द टोटल। सो 3,99,000, 3,99,000 प्लस 60 प्लस 10 70,000, 4,69,000, that is your operating profit before working capital changes, and then we need to do some adjustment for working capital changes, hai na. So let's start from current liabilities. Under current liability, short term borrowing and short term provision and both are adjusted, so it will not come. Under current assets, only inventories are given. So earlier, let's see point number 7, what is given. So point number 7, inventories are given, stock in trade 45 to 107,000. So increase in inventories. Increase in inventories. Let me take out the difference. How much? 45,000 and 107,000. 107,000 minus 45,000, it is 62,000. So increase in inventories result in outflow of cash 62,000. All points are over. Let me subtract 4,69 minus 62. So it will be 4,07,000. We write inner column, because tax paid is to be paid, है ना? Then less tax paid, we have computed tax paid, how much it is given in the question, 70,000 tax paid. So we need to subtract 70,000. Let us subtract 70,000. 4,07,000 minus 70,000 is coming 3,37,000. 3,37,000. Let me check it is correct or not. 3,37,000 cash flow from operating activities. Yes, it is correct. Cash flow from operating activities. Okay, then second activity is cash flow from investing. Let me prepare. Cash flow from investing activity. What do we write in investing activity? Remember, non-current assets plus non-current investment. So let's see what is given in the question. So under non-current assets, 5 and 6 and non-current investment are given. So first I will write about non-current investment. Purchase of non-current investment 25,000. Purchase of non-current investment 25,000. Outflow of cash. Then it is goodwill written in operating activity. Tangible asset mean number 5. Let us go on number 5. Number 5, machinery is given, isn't it? So we have not prepared, there is any account now for machinery. No machinery account is prepared. So let us take the difference of 12,03 and 8,21,000. 12,03,000 minus 8,21,000 is equal to 3,82,000. So purchase of machinery. Purchase of machinery 3,82,000 result in outflow of cash. Let's do the total. So 3,82,000 plus 25,000 is equal to 4,07,000 negative. It is coming, children, negative. It means cash used in investing activity. कैश यूज्ड इन इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी। लेट अस चेक डियर चिल्ड्रन इज करेक्ट और नॉट। 4,07,000 इज करेक्ट, यूज्ड इन इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी। वन मोर पॉइंट इज लेफ्ट, कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी। लेट अस प्रिपेयर थर्ड वन ऑल्सो। कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी। वॉट डू वी राइट इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी? वी राइट शेयर होल्डर फंड प्लस नॉन करेंट लाइबिलिटी। सो लेट अस सी दीज टू वैल्यूज, दीज टू पॉइंट। शेयर होल्डर फंड, सो कम इन द शेयर कैपिटल। 4 lakh to 5 lakh इक्विटी शेयर, इश्यू ऑफ शेयर कैपिटल 1 lakh, इश्यू ऑफ शेयर कैपिटल 1 lakh, रिजल्ट इन इनफ्लो ऑफ कैश। देन लॉन्ग टर्म बोरोइंग, अर्लियर 5 lakh, नाउ 4,50,000, इट इज डिबेंचर्स है ना, सो रिडम्पशन ऑफ डिबेंचर्स 50,000, रिडम्पशन ऑफ डिबेंचर्स 50,000, रिजल्ट इन आउटफ्लो ऑफ कैश। ओके, देन शॉर्ट टर्म बोरोइंग इज ऑल्सो गिवन, पॉइंट नंबर 3। सो लेट्स चेक वॉट इज गिवन। बैंक ओवर ड्राफ्ट, अर्लियर 50,000, नाउ 1,50,000, इंक्रीज इन बैंक ओवर ड्राफ्ट बाय 1 lakh, इंक्रीज इन बैंक ओवर ड्राफ्ट बाय रुपीज 1 lakh, रिजल्ट इन इनफ्लो ऑफ कैश। ओके, एंड वॉट इज इंटरेस्ट ऑन डिबेंचर इज ऑल्सो टू बी पेड ना, सो 12, 5 years, 60,000 इंटरेस्ट ऑन डिबेंचर। We have computed 60,000. Okay, I think all points are over, है ना? So let's do the total. 1 lakh plus 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 2 lakh minus 110, 90,000. So 90,000 positive. So this is cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activity, है ना? Let's check. Yes, 90,000. Let's do the total of all these three. 337. 4,07,000 minus 90,000 and minus 3,37,000 is equal to 20,000 negative. So 20,000 positive, है ना? 20,000 will be positive, so it will be known as net increase in cash and cash equivalent. 1 plus 2 plus 3 total of all activity. Then what do we add? We add opening cash and cash equivalent. Let's see how much it is given. It is given, two values are given, 60 plus 60 120, 1,20,000. When we add, what we get? 1,40,000. This is your closing cash and cash equivalent, hai na? And the total is given 50 and 90. Yes, correct. So 50 plus 90 is equal to 1,40,000. And here opening is 60,000 plus 60,000. Yes, dear children. I hope the question is clear to everyone.